One of the things I learned personally that helped the memorization is what the person eats. The diet affects the person's memory. Wallahi, it does, man. It does. It affects a lot of the people's memory. These people who eat junk food, chicken and chips every single day, Pepsi on the side, yeah, not healthy. Of course, the brain is the function. Your brain, ikhwani, it's made. Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, I didn't read it from the book of Ibn al-Qayyim, I read it from the Murtainis, the Mashana'aqidda. The Murtainis have a very powerful system of learning. They work hard from the beginning to the end. The food system is strong. The food these people eat, from there to what they memorize, affects everything. When you come to the Mashana'aqidda, the Murtainis, they will work on your food for a week before you start memorizing anything. Then when they put you in shape and they know your mind's limada, there are food your body, when it's digesting it, your brain cannot concentrate. So your body cannot function all at the same time. So what they do is they take food which gets to the point, gives them the nutrition, the protein, and then after that effect, the brain is fully ready to take the knowledge. So I think the eating is very important. Also, brothers, is staying away from the ma'asim, the sins. Shakotu ila waqir, we took the call of Al-Imam al-Shafi'i. Abstain from sins. Sins decreases your understanding and your memory. Thirdly, ikhwan, is before you pour anything into your heart, what do you need? You have to clear your heart. Sahih. Can I pour more water into this once it's full? Nah. If your heart is filled up with so much useless information, you know FIFA 2000, what were they playing downstairs before? Hey, youngsters. 2013. Hey, he knows all the players' names. All these are useless information. Things that are wasting your time, wasting your brain, occupying your bright brain. Now what have you done? You want to take Quran in festival, get rid of this, which is already in your brain. That needs to be left in order for something brand new and something fresh to go into your brain. People who've memorized so much music and stuff, things that don't make sense to them. Brothers, what does not benefit you, don't memorize it. Don't. You don't need it, you don't need it. Just focus on what your mind needs in your brain. I see people who today memorize people's numbers off the top of their head. Why do you need to? What's the ghaya in it? Why might as well memorize ayat? I see people, subhanAllah, who memorize addresses. When you send them a phone call and you say, told this address, he'll say, okay, what's the number? What's the postcode? Barakallah. Write it down. No, I don't need my memory. But when Quran, I can't memorize. So memorize what's beneficial for you. You knowing the address of my house from the top of your head, is it beneficial? My phone number off the top of your head, is it beneficial? The reality is not. What is beneficial is that you know that if you're going to memorize numbers, then memorize all the hadith in Sahih Bukhari and the numbers. MashaAllah. That's needed. The benefit, the ayat of the hadith, ayat of the surahs, memorize that. Now, don't waste your time. Also, brothers, wallahi, always repeat what you've already memorized. I realize that some people, when they read ayah, they read it 5 times, they get tired and say, oh, I read it, wallahi, I can't memorize it. Maybe some people, mashallah, 5 times is enough. Some people, 10 times is enough. Some 50, some 100, some 200. You haven't reached a point where you've mastered yourself. Brothers, some people don't even know themselves. Go home, learn yourself. What type of person am I? Am I the fast learner, quick memorizer, or am I not? If you're not a fast learner, you can't memorize quickly, then you are the ones that learn. It takes time for you to learn. So do what it takes you. 50 times, then do the 50 times. 70 times, some people memorize properly, do the 70 times. So the important thing is, brothers, you master yourself. Na'am, Imam al-Bukhari used to hear it once and he used to memorize it. Hada Bukhari. That's Imam al-Bukhari. That's not me, AbdulRahman. Wallahi. I can't forget something I memorized. I memorized 50 times, for instance. I'm going to go home. I'm going to do 50. I know if I do 49, I'm not going to memorize. Why am I going to copy my friend here, Ghalib, who does 10 times and he memorizes? And I think I'm not doing enough. No. Allah created us different. He's 10, he's gifted. I'm not. I'm 50. So I'm always working on. So knowing what you need in order to memorize. The Shana'aqidda, the Murtainis, are the people who have been astonished with the way they memorize. Each time they write 200, 300 times. 200-300 times actually they write it down. When you bring this, the way they do it, the istidlan, the way it comes out of their mouth, ikhwan, is something else. SubhanAllah. Never ever you see anyone like this, man. The brain capacity. You know why? Wallahi, they're not people who have a stronger brain than the rest of the people. They're not. They're just normal people. But what they've mastered is two things, brothers. They've got to know themselves first, and then they've mastered themselves. Secondly, is ikhwan, these people had the excess conscientiousness and the effort and the never-ending determination. And yeah, that's the thing I say. Determination is where people pass each other. You see, 2 times reading, I'm tired. And you give up. No, wallahi, don't do that. Carry until it soaks in. Until, wallahi, what I do, I have a method of learning myself. What I do is, I go home, for example, I want to memorize the Mudhumma to Mimi, for example, at home. I go, I have a recording system. I go home, I memorize, I read it there, I recite it in there. For 2 months, this iPad that I have, it will be right next to my pillow. It's on a replay. The whole day in my car, my way there, my way back, the extensive of my wife's reading with me. Yeah, I put it next to in the living room, we listen to it. Sometimes for 2 months, every single day I listen to it. The next 2 months comes, I do the same. What do I do? After 2 months, I know it. Yeah. I know now idea of what I heard it. I haven't yet opened the papers. So I sit down, I look for a copy version of it. I sit down and I look at the copied version and then I memorize it. Now it's gonna be 50 times reading it. Or 40 or 30, whatever. Then I give it to my wife and I say, listen to me, inshallah. She takes it from me, she listens to me. Never do I hope that to leave me. And that's how it stays. It stays there forever. Listening to something will help it stick in your brain and reading it too much. Nah.